إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. I just want to let you know that we'll allow maybe half an hour for you to do Adhkar al-Sabah. So we'll just do 20-30 minutes maximum, and then after that you can carry on your own remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala until Fajr, until Shuruq. And then you pray two rak'ahs, you get the reward bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. قرأنا في صلاة الفجر قصة قارون. We recited في صلاة الفجر the final verses almost or close in سورة القصص. أن الشيخ وليد حفظه الله افتتح القصص في التهجد. الشيخ وليد started القصص في التهجد، وقرأنا منها ما تيسر. We recited قصة قارون, the story of قارون. وقارون يا إخوة غني جاهل, رجل غني, a rich person but ignorant. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم في حديث أخرجه الإمام الترمذي والنسائي وأحمد بسند صحيح, حديث أبي كبش الأنماري رضي الله عنه, the Prophet told us that you can be one of four types of people in this world. There are four types of human beings in this world. But here is the hadith. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم ثلاثة أقسم عليهن. Three things I'm willing to take an oath on. Number one, ما نقص مال من صدقة. That your wealth will never decrease because of charity, because of giving out from it as charity. Two, وما صبر عبد على مظلمة إلا وزاده الله بها عزا. A servant of Allah who is wronged or injustice committed against him and he endures patience, by the virtue of his patience Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will elevate him, will honor him, will raise his rank. Three, وَمَا فَتَحَ عَبْدٌ عَلَى نَفْسِهِ بَابَ مَسْأَلَةٍ إِلَّا وَفَتَحَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ بَابَ فَقْرٍ. Someone who goes around begging people with no need just to get their money as a profession, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will increase him in poverty. Listen, وَإِنِّي مُحَدِّثُكُمْ حَدِيثًا فَاحْفَظُوهُ. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم actually commanded us to memorize this hadith. I'm going to tell you a hadith, I want you to memorize it. إنما الدنيا لأربعة نفر. There are four types of people in this world, in this dunya. One, رجل آتاه الله, or رجل, both are ضبطين is correct. رجل آتاه الله علما ومالا. Look at the first one. A rich scholar. Someone whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given money and knowledge. Knowledge, شرعي, علم شرعي, علم الدين, علم العقيدة, علم التوحيد, علم الحلال والحرام. رجل آتاه الله علما ومالا, شوف, فهو يتقي فيه ربه. Because of the knowledge, he has taqwa, consciousness of Allah regarding his wealth. How? Meaning, he earns it from lawful ways. He doesn't earn the money from haram, because he knows لا تزول قدم عبد يوم القيامة حتى يسأل عن أربع, وفي لفظ عن خمس. In the day of resurrection, your feet will not move out of the day, out of the land of gathering on the day of resurrection, without being asked about five things. Two questions about money. وعن ماله, about his wealth. من أين اكتسبه, how did he earn it. وفيما أنفقه, and how did he spend it. So he has wealth, but he has knowledge. That knowledge led him to have taqwa regarding his wealth. Once it comes to earning it and using it, فهو يتقي فيه ربه. يا إخوة, النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said, والله, by Allah, ما الفقر أخشى عليكم. I do not fear poverty on you. I'm actually fearing that you will have a lot of wealth. Huge fitna, حب المال, the love of money. وتحبون المال حبا جما. Muslims now would do whatever it takes just to earn the money without even looking into how it was earned. Subhanallah, just to show you that this fitna, not many people can be saved from it. ولذلك يا إخوة, الإمام البخاري رحمه الله, in his Sahih, he compiled in كتاب الرقاق a chapter, and he given it a very weird title. You know what he said? باب فضل الفقر. He called it this, باب, the virtue of poverty. Why? Because the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, اطلعت إلى الجنة. I looked at Jannah. And we know this happened the night of the ascension. فوجدت أن أكثر أهلها من الفقراء. I found the majority of the dwellers of Jannah from the poor and needy. Where are the rich? Where? They failed. يعني, the majority of them. Now, Imam al-Bukhari, even so, the scholars did not like that. لأن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم استعاذ بالله من الفقر. النبي said, وأعوذ بك من الفقر والجوع فإنه بئس الضجيع. واللفظ الثاني, وأعوذ بك من الفقر والكفر. I seek refuge with you from poverty. فأنت ازاي, how come يا بخاري تيجي وتقول فضل الفقر, the virtue of poverty, بس he has a point to make too. If what it takes for me to make it to Jannah that I spend the 67 years in this dunya poor, أنا أعملها يا عم الحج والله أعملها. ما هو الموضوع كله 67 years، أنت متخيل إيه يعني 67 years it will be over. أعمار أمتي، the lifespan of my ummah is between what؟ بين 60 و70، وقليل منهم من يجاوز ذلك. وبعدين عندك you have another problem، حديث أنس يؤتى بأنعم أهل الأرض من أهل النار. Imagine someone who had it all figured out in this world. Very, leading a very luxurious lifestyle. He has everything he wants. رجل منعم. Someone who has all type of luxury. But he's a dweller of hell. Look. فيغمس غمسة واحدة في النار. He will be dipped one time in hell. Then he will be taken out and he will be asked, هل رأيت نعيما قط؟ Do you recall any of the fun that you had in this world? لا والله يا رب. Forgotten يا رب. Gone. Look at the other side. ويؤتى بأبأس أهل الأرض من أهل الجنة. Imagine someone who had a miserable life, but he's a dweller of Jannah. He will be dipped one time in Jannah. And then he will be asked, هل رأيت بؤسا قط? Do you recall any misery that you experienced in the world? لا والله يا رب. Gone. هو الإمام البخاري has a point to make. وبعدين not only this. فقراء المسلمين يدخلون الجنة قبل أغنيائهم بنصف يوم. The poor of the Muslims will enter Jannah before the rich of the Muslims. Someone like Abdul Rahman ibn Auf. كان غني. But look. The poor will enter Jannah before the rich of the Muslims half a day. How long is half a day? 500 years. ليه؟ لأن الرجل ما عندوش حاجة. ما هو الإيه؟ You're going to have to stand in front of Allah. How did you earn this dollar? How did you earn the dollar? Oh, Ya Rab, I got a loan from the bank and I went into business and I paid Mr. Sam 7%. طب, this is usury. للتكبيض. يلا. اشرب. How did you earn it? Oh, Ya Rab, I cheated somebody out of his money. Answer. Every dollar, you're going to have to answer. ما هو العلم, knowledge is what? Knowledge will help you with what? وشوف يا إخوة, سبحان الله, look at the Muslim businessmen. You find him having now, as we speak, at this time, all type of experts, all type of analysts, people who analyze, people, he would do all type of studies. But he calls a student of knowledge, Sheikh, I'm about to get into this business transaction. Can you please look at the contract and verify whether it is... ما يفعل. وإحنا ببلاش. We are for free. We don't ask for money. يكلمنا... We don't ask for fee when you call us. For free. Fatwa for free. But he has an accountant who charge him what? CP whatever, huh? So much money. Oh, this guy does this work, oh, this analyze, oh, feasibility study, ومش عارف ايه. بس, is this business transactions right in the sight of Allah, in the sight of Allah or not? You're going to be asked about this. من أين اكتسبه? Also, وفيما أنفقه. شوف, رجل, this is, we're still talking about number one. رجل آتاه الله مالا وعلما. The first type of people in this earth, someone whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed upon him wealth and knowledge. فهو يتقي فيه ربه. Look. ويصل به رحمه. And he uses this money to uphold his kinship ties. Now the first place that the people should benefit from your wealth is what? Who? Your family. لما نزلت الآية لن تنالوا البر حتى تنفقوا مما تحبون. You will never be able to attain righteousness and piety, meaning entering Jannah, يعني, unless you spend from that which you love most. Abu Talha al-Ansari said, Ya Rasulullah, Inna ahabba mali ilayya bi'ru bayruha. The most beloved of my wealth is a garden called Bayruha. Hiya lillah ya Rasulullah. Look, ij'alha fi ahlik. Shuf. Lala, give it to your family. ما هو الصدقة على الغريب, when you give a stranger is just a صدقة. But الصدقة to your neighbor, to your relative is what? صدقة وصلة. Mean. Wise. But who likes his relatives now to give them صدقة? Huh? Who? Tell me. We don't like one another anymore. We're trouble, envy, حسد فسدت يا إخوة. فساد ذات البين هذا مشكلة. بس الرجل العالم تقي يستخدم هذا المال في صلة الرحم. طيب, so this is number one, we don't want to prolong this. شوف number two, الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم said regarding this one, وهذا أفضل المنازل. This is the best that you can be. يعني if you want to wish, يا رب, I want to be rich, but knowledge too. Because this knowledge will what? وشوف علي بن أبي طالب رضي الله عنه, when he said, or when he compared wealth and knowledge, what did he say? Something about wealth, you have to guard it. But something about knowledge, knowledge guards you. Knowledge protects you. But wealth, you have to protect the wealth from the thief, from the cheaters. All day long, you have to look for your wealth. Who's stealing? Who's stealing? Huh? Who's taking away my money? Where is my money? But knowledge guard you. You're about to do something wrong. اتق الله, قال الله, قال رسول الله. استغفر الله. Back off. For this is what you should wish to be. طيب. Number two. ورجل آتاه الله علما ولم يؤته مالا. Look at the second type. Someone whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given knowledge but no money. But look, that knowledge does so much for him. The best of it, it purifies his intention. It makes him clean. He would wish to be like the first one. And this is what is meant in Hadith Abdullah ibn Mas'ud رضي الله عنه في الصحيحين, لا حسد إلا في اثنتين. Envy is bad except in one case, that you wish to be some like someone who is wealthy and who spends in the cause of Allah, someone who has knowledge and he shares, teaches that knowledge. Oh. You can wish to be that. ولذلك العلماء يقولون هذه غبطة, that you wish to be like the person without hoping that he loses what he has. غير الحسد. Different to الحسد, different to envy. الحسد that you wish the person loses the ni'mah. Man, this guy has a nice car. He wants him to lose the car. هذا هو الحسد. We call it destructive envy, but this one is called constructive envy, that you want to be like this. فهذا الرجل, look at the second man, he doesn't have money, but he has knowledge, that knowledge purified his intention, And he would say, Ya Rabb, O Allah, لو أن لي مثل فلان, if I have the wealth of so and so, the first one, لعملت بعملي, I will do like him. Guess what? Because of that intention, he receives the same exact reward of the first one. بالنية. He reaches his rank. No. You ready for number three? وده number three اللي قرأناه في الصلاة. اللي هو ايه؟ غني جاهل. ورجل آتاه الله مالا ولم يؤته علما. And someone whom, قارون, هذا قارون. Someone whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given money without knowledge. Look how the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam expressed it. فهو يخبط في ماله. يخبط. You know what يخبط is? تعرفين ايه؟ Just messing around with his money. لا يتقي فيه ربه ولا يصل فيه رحمه. به رحمه. He earns it whatever. Whatever can make him money, whether dealing in drugs, whether doing usury, whether selling liquor, whether there are Muslims who have liquor stores. You believe that? Unbelievable. Muslims have liquor stores. وبعدين يجي يقول لك ايه يا عم الحاج اتق الله, يقول لك عمل ببيع الكفار, انت مال احنا مالنا انا مسلم كفار. اذا حرم الله شيئا حرم ثمنه. وبعدين لعن الله الخمر وبائعها, ما قالش بائعها. الله curses the one who sells liquor. Allah did not say, the messenger of Allah did not say whether you're selling it to a Muslim or a non-Muslim. يخبط, هو عايز ايه؟ What he worries about is money. خلاص. زي قارون. وانت عارف the ignorant rich, الغني الجاهل, the worst thing that he makes the statement which قارون made. قال إنما أوتيته على علم عندي. That's the worst thing that you can do. That you believe that you got this wealth because of what? Because you're smart. Because of your skills. طب كيبت يا سقارون. فخسفنا به. Earth swallowed him and swallowed his wealth. ما هو يقول لك يا إخوة, شوف الكلام هذا كلام العلماء الأكابر. Tell you that an individual would look at the bounty of Allah two ways. النظرة القارونية والنظرة السليمانية. The سليماني look and the قاروني look. قارون said what? I got this because of what? Of me, بذاتي. طب نبي الله سليمان, when he, والشيخ وليد حفظه الله برضو قرأ علينا سورة النمل في التهجد, when he wanted the throne of بلقيس, the queen of Sheba, أيكم يأتيني بعرشها قبل أن يأتوني مسلمين, who can bring me her throne, قال عفريت من الجن أنا آتيك به قبل أن تقوم من مقامك وإني عليه لقوي أمين. One of the jinn, Afrit, he said, he used to sit in that gathering, the scholars of tafsir say maybe 2 to 3 hours. 2 to 3 hours, by the time you finish this gathering, you finish, you will find it here and I will take care of it. He didn't like it yet. شوف, قال الذي عنده علم من الكتاب. The one who had the knowledge. Another jinni, but he had the knowledge. أنا آتيك به قبل أن يرتد إليك طرفك. I will bring it to you before what? Blink.
ولذلك شوف القرآن. The Quran did not say then he traveled and then he got the throne and he came. But شوف فلما رآه مستقرا عنده. Because he did this, he saw the throne. What did he say? What did he say? شايف؟ قال هذا من فضل ربي. This is from the bounty of Allah upon me. ليبلوني. To test me. أأشكر أم أكفر. Whether I'm going to be grateful or whether I'm going to be ungrateful. لئيم. فنظرة قارون نظرة لؤم. إنك تظن, you think that what you have, هو مشكلة الغني مع الجهل, الغنى مع الجهل في هذا. The problem with riches, with ignorance is this, that you're going to, that's the first mistake, that you're going to think that wealth is there for you. Not only this, by the way, one of the worst things that the rich who are ignorant, they think that the fact they do have money is a sign that Allah loves them. And this is the worst. إن الله يعطي الدنيا لمن يحب ومن لا يحب. Allah would give this world to those whom He loves and those whom He does not love. وَيُعْطِ الدِّينِ. But the religion, الإيمان, too. الآخرة لم يثبت يا إخوة. لفظ الآخرة لم يثبت. يُعْطِ الدِّينِ وَيُعْطِ الْإِيمَانِ. He would give the religion to those whom He loves. ما شوف الـ واضرب لهم مثل الرجلين جعلنا لأحدهما جنتين من أعناب وحففناهما بنخل وجعلنا بينهما زرعا. عمل إيه؟ ودخل جنته وهو ظالم لنفسه. شوف 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 شوف. قال ما أظن أن تبيد هذه أبدا. أنت you know the stick shift, the car stick shift. That's one. I don't think my garden will ever perish. Not two. وَمَا أَظُنُّ السَّاعَةَ قَائِمَةً. And I don't think there is a day of judgment. Three. وَلَئِنْ رُدِدْتُ إِلَىٰ رَبِّي. And if I go back to Allah, Allah will give me something much better than this because I'm special. I'm so special. I'm special. جهل. هذا جهل. هذا ignorance. ما يفهم. ما يفهم السنن الربانية ولا يفهم إن المال ابتلاء والصحة. He doesn't understand that wealth is a test, health is a test, children is a test. ونبلوكم بالشر والخير فتنة. الإنسان يبتلى في هذه الدنيا, يبتلى بالخير. You get tested. You get tested by wealth. How are you gonna deal with it? فالشاهد غني جاهل. So how many did we mention so far? What was number one? A knowledgeable rich person or a rich who is knowledgeable. Two, knowledgeable but poor. Three, rich but شوف the worst is the fourth one. لا فلوس ولا علم. No money, no wealth. And those who reacted to Qarun's prestige. شوف فخرج على قومه في زينته. ما هو قارون, ما هو من القارون, how rich is قارون. I have never seen an expression like this in my life. He is so wealthy that he would need up to 12 people not to carry his wealth, to carry the keys to his wealth. ما إن مفاتيحه لتنوء, يعني it would be heavy still, بالعصبة أولي القوة. أهو شوف فخرج على قومه في زينته, خارج طبعا في الهيلمان بتاعه. قال الذين يريدون الحياة الدنيا يا ليت لنا مثل ما أوتي قارون. So this is number four. ورجل لم يؤته الله علما ولا مالا. Someone whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not bestow upon him wealth nor knowledge. فهو يقول, he will say, لو أن لي مثل فلان, if I am like قارون, يا ليت لنا مثل ما أوتي قارون, I will do like قارون. Guess what? Because of his intention, he receives the sin of this man. Because of his intention. In closing, يا إخوة, what distinguished these four individuals? ما الذي فرق بين الأربعة نفر في الحديث؟ إيه اللي فرق؟ What? Knowledge. The knowledge protected the rich from his wealth. The knowledge purified the poor and purified his intention that he wished to be someone who is good in the sight of Allah. The knowledge destroyed the rich. The third, the knowledge messed up the poor because he didn't have it. العلم. العلم. ولذلك تعجب. You're amazed. The first word, the first command in our religion, when Jibreel alayhi salam descended upon our messenger and he recited to him the first verse, what did he say to him? What? Iqra. Learn, yeah. Learn. وشوف سبحان الله, always after the story of Adam and Satan is concluded in the Quran, just check it out in so many places. But let's take the context of Surah Taha. قلنا اهبطا منها جميعا. Go down to earth. فإما يأتينكم مني هدى. I'm going to send you guidance, knowledge. فمن اتبع هدايا فلا يضل ولا يشقى. Whosoever follows it will never go astray, nor he will be enriched. Nor he will be enriched, يعني unhappy. طيب, ومن أعرض عن ذكري. And whoever turns away from that knowledge, from the reminder, فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضُنْكَ. Miserable life. لذلك يا إخوة تعجب, والله stats out of this world. The highest income in the world is in a country called Sweden. The highest income, money. You know what too? The highest suicide is in this country. Suicide is in this country too. Because money is not what gives you happiness. That's what gives you happiness is knowledge, the remembrance of Allah. This heart will never find happiness until this heart knows it, the creator. شوف انت كده, look how you feel when you remember Allah, when you pray. بالله عليك, look how you feel now. They sit in the bar for 3-4 hours. Just to feel half what you're having. Half. And at the end of the night, he wastes his money and he vomits in the trash في الآخر. ويروح البيت عامل لك كده. And in his way, he probably gonna hit somebody, kill somebody. And his wife is going to yell at him or maybe call the police on him. Misery. شوف. ما الدنيا لا تحلو إلا بذكر الله. والله يا إخوة. والله لا تحلو هذه الدنيا إلا بذكر الله. ولذلك سلفنا الصالح يقول والله إنا لفي سعادة لو علم بها ملوك الأرض لجالدون عليها. By Allah, we experience sometimes moments of happiness, moments of joy. If the kings on earth would know about it, they would come and try to take it away from us. ويقول لك ابن تيمية يقول لك إن لفي جنة. أنا في جنة. I'm always in جنة. What my enemy is going to do to me? If he kills me, I'm a martyr. If he jails me, that's i'tikaf, seclusion. And if he expels me, سياحة في سبيل الله. Can you beat that? You can't defeat that. ولا تهنوا ولا تحزنوا وأنتم الأعلون but a conditional إن كنتم مؤمنين. Despair not, because you are superior if you are believers. I leave you at this. I don't want to break my promise, so I leave you inshallah doing your adhkar until the sun rises, and you pray your two rak'ahs بإذن الله تعالى. But in general, knowledge is important. Try to find a way to learn your religion, to learn your deen. It will make a huge difference. Wallahi, knowledge will make a huge difference in your life. Make it a habit every week that you're going to listen to a lecture. You're going to read maybe half of a book or 5-10 pages, whatever you can. Ya akhi, put a book next to your bed. Put a book before you go to sleep. Just read 3-4 pages. وشوف how this will change your lives. هات الرحيق المختوم, the seals, nectar. ولا هات the book of hadith. وتفسير القرآن. Simple تفسير. Start somewhere. You will see. It will make a big difference in your lives. جزاكم الله خيرا. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم والحمد لله رب العالمين.